Hi again. After rigging the tops and placing the subs, we are ready to find out the speaker connected to the Control 8 via RDNet. This is the most common way to work. After designing, wiring, rigging and powering the system, press the controller's button in the toolbar and discover for the controllers. The controllers found will appear in the Found Controller window. By pressing Match, we'll add the controller to our workspace. Now, press Quick Start. This command is available only when the workspace is empty. As we can see, we have all the objects. Left cluster, right cluster, and subs, but without order. We have to work to build a synoptic design with sense, placing the main left in the left area, as well as the main right. Holding down the right button of the mouse, we have the pan tools that allow to drag the workspace, as well as the mouse wheel can be used to zoom in and out quickly. The subs are physically placed in two rows of four subs each. We can arrange the subs simply placing the first one on the left and overlapping the others one by one. They'll automatically take the right position aligned with the previous ones. Let's zoom a single module to display its primary attributes. Device logical identification numbers, the unique address that the speaker will take within the system after the quick start command. Every ID consists of three numbers. First, controller number. Second, controller line number. Third, device number in the line. Start counting from the top, as the wiring direction must always be in the arrays. Starting from an object ID, it is possible to find its physical location. So, if we have a problem in the speaker 1, 2, 5, it means that we'll check the speaker number 5 in the line 2, in this case the right cluster. This way to address the speakers is very helpful, especially working in big systems. Looking at the icon of the speaker, this module, for some reasons, is off. Device model, HF current preset. Mute button. Menu button to assess the extended parameters. Input signal level. Limiter intervention gain reduction. EQ button to assess the DSP parameters, equalization, gain, delay, etc. Low frequency current preset. Device status of each way, blinking green when the output level is normal. Yellow and red means respectively soft compression and hard limiter intervention. Double clicking on the icon of a module will go to the extended attributes, which are specific for each device. We have group button to assign this speaker to a group. Limiter intervention level by way. View meters of the output level by way. Amplifier status by way. Mute button by way. Solo button. Bypass or local status. All RDNet devices have a bypass or local button in the rear panel. This option concerns the device onboard DSP about which configuration will be loaded when rebooting. If that button is released, the DSP will load the local manual setting. If it is pressed, the DSP will load the last settings received by RDNet. The software indicates the bypass or local button status by changing the color of the object ID. If the color is blue, the bypass button on the device is not pressed. If by mistake the cluster already flown has some bypass released, we can force the bypass ongoing in advanced bypass override enabled. This will lock all the devices in the workspace, and only with RDNet we can work on them. This is the indication of the amplifier temperature, amplifier main voltage, cooling fan speed, device angle indication, high frequency and low frequency current presets. Now we are ready to tune and align the system. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.